All right, in Google Sheets, sometimes you want to filter a table of data. We're going to look at the filter function, talk about how it works, and look at a few examples. I'll see you inside the video. Just start out by typing filter, and then it wants the range. So the range is kind of the source data, if you will. It's the original table. So we'll say A1 through A4. And when you use the filter function, unlike using the filter through the menus, it keeps the source data as is. All right, so we'll hit a comma, and the next thing that it wants is the condition. In this case, we're going to specify the same cells because we want it when any of the cells in A1 through A4 are less than 4. All right, so we're done with the first simple example here. Hit enter, and it just returns what's called an array. It's a dynamic array, and it writes it into the cell where the formula was, so that's A6 and below. And when we get through to two columns later, it'll also write it to the right. So be careful when you're using these, because if there's a value already to the right or below where this was intended to go, so let's say there's something in A8, the function will give you an error. And then the other nice thing about this function is that if the source data is updated, so let's say we change A2 to something below 4, you'll see below where the function is, that it will dynamically update in real time. So whenever your data changes, filter function is always up to date. All right, so now we'll look at an example of the filter function having two columns. And I'll fill out the second column here. And we'll just go into the existing filter function. We'll change a few things. So the range, you can just make it multiple columns. Okay, so the filter function can be as many columns as you want. But we can still use this same argument. So the argument with the condition, the range for the condition, doesn't need to be the entire size of the source data. So if we say less than 4, it still returns the column with the numbers in it. But since the range goes to B, it will return the other corresponding values. So that's a really powerful aspect of the filter function, is you can control how many columns it returns. All right, so for the third example, well, we'll go back into this filter function, and we're going to specify, for some reason in the example, and you can get a copy of this example spreadsheet. If you go to sheetshelp.com, I'll go to it here, /filter, you can get a copy of the Google Sheet right here. Put it in your Google Drive, so just make your own copy and follow along. But for some reason in these examples, I changed. We're going to do multiple criteria. The first one now is equal to 3 instead of less than 4. And the second one we're going to say, now we're just going to specify the second column, B1 to B4. But remember to make it the same height. And here we'll say equal to the letter B. But because it's a string, which is a letter instead of a number, just make sure you surround it in quotes. If you don't do that, it won't work. And you hit enter, and the filter function updates now. And you'll notice that because there's two conditions, both of them need to be met. So we're going to work around that in the next example. But when you use this with the standard syntax, it has to have a 3 and a B. So it's only returning that one value. And for our last example, we're going to do a trick that actually I didn't know about until I researched this video. We're going to change the syntax a little bit to make these two conditions an OR type of match instead of an AND. So A1 through A4 can be a 3, or column B can have a B in it. So what we do, we take parentheses and surround both of these arguments. And then just change the comma. And these commas may be semicolons depending on where you live. United States are commas. But if you live in a country where the comma is a decimal separator, these will be semicolons. But regardless, change it to a plus, hit enter. So you get an array where either column B has a B in it, or column A is equal to 3. So that's why row 8 is here. So the filter function, this is all the basic usage of it, but there are some more advanced things you can do. And one of them is you can mostly use it as an alternative to the XLOOKUP function. All right, so this next video is going to take the two functions and compare them. I promise you'll learn a little bit as you go through it. And I'll see you in that next video. Thanks for watching.